Welcome to the course Big SQL on Hadoop. In this lesson, Big SQL Overview, you will get an introduction to Big SQL and see how to use Big SQL on Hadoop data. After completing this lesson, you will be able to describe the Big SQL architecture. Know the differences between the current Big SQL and its older version. We will refer to this as Big SQL version 1. List some of the Big SQL features. Understand Big SQL terminologies. Understand and use different methods for working with Big SQL. There are multiple tools available for you to work with your data on Hadoop. You have your MapReduce, which is highly scalable but requires the user to understand the Java API and have some programming expertise. What if you do not want anything to do with Java? Well, then you can learn or use Pig, Jekyll, Hive, or a number of other tools to work with your data. No? You do not want to learn anything new? Well, good news. Big SQL provides a common and familiar syntax that lets you work with your data. You can query your data residing in Hadoop using Big SQL. There is no learning curve here. Big SQL is about applying SQL to your existing data. There are no proprietary storage formats. What is Big SQL? Simply put, Big SQL is a logical view on top of your Hadoop data. The data resides in Hadoop, and all you have to do is use Big SQL to access it. There is no need to change the format or migrate the data out of Hadoop to do any work on the data. Big SQL supports modern SQL 2011 capabilities. So, when you migrate your data into Hadoop, the same SQL can be used on your warehouse data with little or no modifications. That is one of the big benefits of Big SQL. No need to learn anything new, and you can use your existing queries. Big SQL is designed for performance. It replaces MapReduce using a modern, massively parallel processing, or MPP architecture. The compiler and runtime are written in native code, C or C++, so it is much faster. The SQL engine pushes down the processing to the same node that holds the data, so all the processing happens locally at the data. There is also no startup latency. The daemons are continuously running. The operations occur in memory, and if necessary, it can spill over to disk for processing. This allows for support of aggregations and sorts much larger than the available RAM. In this diagram here, you can see the Big SQL daemons that run on each node in the cluster, in orange. You have one master node, the one at the top. The master node is responsible for accepting client connections, accepting queries, doing all the queries planning, query optimization, and then the pushing of the query down to the worker nodes below. The other color boxes are the independent support processes that aid Big SQL in its processing. At the top right corner, you can see that there is the Hive metastore involved. Hive is still using it. Big SQL communicates and shares information with Hive. The scheduler is the main interface between Big SQL and Hadoop. Remember that Big SQL provides a logical view of the file stored on Hadoop, so it needs to know which file constitutes a table, how many files there are, type of files, etc. It communicates with the scheduler to ask these questions. The scheduler also acts like the MapReduce job tracker. For example, when Big SQL gets a query, it tells the scheduler which table it is going to scan, and then the query predicates to let the scheduler figure out in how many pieces the work can be split. Then that information is passed back to the Big SQL master node to let it run. The worker nodes also communicate with the scheduler to figure out on which split it needs to work at runtime. There is a DDL processing engine, as you can see in the diagram. This engine is responsible for taking a statement and turning it into something Hive and Big SQL can understand. It receives the statements from the native database engine to decompose it to something the database can understand. It decomposes to Hive DDL in order to populate the Hive metastore. Then the scheduler is notified of the new table. One thing to note is that the DDL is run in a fenced mode process, or FMP, which is an isolated process to ensure that it does not affect the other processes. Here we have our I/O processing engine. With Big SQL, we have two processing engines. We have a native I/O engine. The code for this engine is written in C, C++, and is highly optimized. It only knows a specific set of file formats as listed here. We also wanted to handle any Hive tables as defined in the Hive catalog. If we see a particular table that isn't recognized, we hand it down to the Java I/O layer. The Java I/O layer handles all other formats via the standard Hadoop or Hive APIs. Both of these engines are optimized and parallelized, with multiple threads doing the I/O. Also in this diagram, note the UDF-FMP, the pink box. The user-defined functions also run in a separate process in order to isolate the database engine from the user code to prevent the user from doing any harm, just as with the DDL processing engine in the previous slide.